You know how you get those dishes that are just like the taste of home, right? Well, this is mine. It's an East African Indian dish made with chickpeas, potatoes, and a lovely spiced tamarind sauce. Absolutely delicious, completely plant-based, and I want to share it with you because I think it's something that you're going to love. Hey guys, Ash here at The Cheeky Indian, bringing you our take on Indianish food that will blow your taste buds apart. So before I jump into today's recipe, I just want to say a massive thank you to all of the guys that subscribed already. It really helps and your love is so much appreciated. And if you're new to the channel, guys, what are you waiting for? Smash the subscribe button, keep up to date with all things cheeky and join our tribe. And as a massive thank you, we've added a new feature on our website where we link our recipe blog with the videos. So from now on, you're going to have a printable recipe at hand whenever you want. Just log on to the website, press the link in all of our videos, it will take you straight there and you won't miss a thing. Sounds good, right? Right, okay, that's enough of that. I'm ready. Are you ready? Let's get cracking. So we're going to start off with a little look around the ingredients. This is what we're going to be cooking with today. There's not much here, but everything packs a punch. We're looking for a really flavorsome dish with some really simple ingredients, and that's what we're going to get. Now there is a massive surprise element to this dish, but you're not going to find out what that is until the end. So stick around and make sure you watch the whole video. Ooh, has that got you bubbling? Well, it should do, because you'll never guess what this ingredient is. I know, I'm a spoiled sport. Well, what can I say? On with the recipe now. Anyway, enough of the teasing. So in the nice hot pan, we've got a drizzle of veg oil and some whole spices. We've got some cassia bark and 3 or 4 cloves. We're going to actually leave these in there throughout the whole dish. They're going to infuse the oil, but they're going to add so much more to the actual dish. Now we've got 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds. Drop these in, watch the oil cloud up, give everything a little swirl around, and then we'll be ready for our potatoes. So this is about 400 grams of parboiled potatoes. We've cut them to about 1.5 inch size cubes. Next up is our chickpeas. So we're using black chickpeas. These are tin chickpeas. It's absolutely fine. Drain off the fluid and drop them straight in. Now we've got 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder and 1 teaspoon of salt. Just drop it all straight on top. Now there's 1 tablespoon of ground ginger and chilies, equal mix, finely ground. And now our star ingredient, the tamarind pulp. Now this is fresh tamarind pulp, but you can buy bottled from supermarkets. It's absolutely fine. There's about 3 tablespoons here, so we're going to need about 2 teaspoons of sugar to balance this out. Just a quick note that if you're using the tamarind syrup, you may not need to add the sugar, so make sure you taste it first. Give everything a really good mix and then drop in 1.5 cups of cold water. Next is our final ingredient, and that is literally 1 tablespoon of tomato puree. Give everything a really good stir and you'll notice you have this lovely tamarind broth. It's a great time to taste it for balance. And if you need to add anything, just do it now. It should be fine if you stick to these ingredients. We're looking for seasoning, so salt for that, and balance between sweet and sour, so extra tamarind or extra sugar, if needed. Perfect, so lid on, medium heat for 5 minutes, let the sauce thicken up. Great time to remind you that the full ingredients and method, detailed method, is on our recipe blog on our website. The link is in the description. So if you've liked what you've seen so far, remember to smash the like button and hit subscribe to keep up to date with all our tips, tricks, and recipes. Perfect timing. Look at this. Oh my god. Bubbling perfectly. So right, so the consistency we're looking for here is like a good Sunday roast gravy. Have a little taste again. You'll notice that the chickpeas are slightly al dente. Well, that's black chickpeas. That's exactly how they're supposed to be. As you can see, the sauce has thickened up slightly as well from the starch in the potatoes. This dish is best served nice and bubbling hot. So get yourself a nice pasta dish or a soup bowl, something like this, and pour in as much as you can handle. And while it's still hot, we want to jump in with our garnishes. Now it's the garnishes that make this dish. So we've started off with a little sprinkling of onion, some chopped coriander, a sprinkling of chili powder. And are you ready for the secret ingredient? The one we've been waiting for? Well, here we go. Yes, you've guessed it. It's ready salted crisps. Yes, ready salted crisp. No, I haven't got mad, honestly. This adds so much texture and it's the perfect accompaniment for this dish. Just look at how delicious and appetizing this really looks. Right, so there's one more surprise, and that surprise is what we're gonna mop it up with. And no, it's not naan, it's not flatbread, it's French bread. That's right, baguette, wedges of baguette. Perfect to mop up this beautiful tamarind-based chickpea and potato curry. Just look at all those spices, look at all that color, look at all that flavor. Can't think of anything better than to mop it up with a lovely thick piece of bread. have a taste. Well, it's rude to speak with my mouth full, so I'm going to have to disappear. But before I do, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy making this dish. It's an absolute family favourite of mine. So remember, the next video is coming up right now. And hit like, smash subscribe, and join the Cheeky Indian tribe.